This is regular leather armor. Protector of the Second, plus two. The Mist of Shadows were an elite group of elven rangers that roamed the Cormanthar Wood and were the bane of bandits and monsters alike. This particular armor was worn by Indira Lakan, one of the group's most highly decorated officers and second in command. The suit is named for her, though how it came to part her company is unknown. Armor class 6. So it's not as good as the other. It is as good as the other. 4 versus slashing, 5 versus piercing and missile. Yeah, this is not as good as... Okay, so we're going to be selling that armor. Okay, what about this longsword? Harrower, plus 1. We're finding some awesome equipment now. This double-edged longsword gleams white in an even the reddest of torchlight. The Deathek runes along its side name the blade Harrower, a weapon once wielded by Ariabel, a Waterdavian paladin of Lathander who once carried the weapon into combat against the vampire Xerifex and her host of unholy spawn. Ariabel did not survive the contest, but decades later, a group of Tetherian tomb robbers recovered her sword from the crypt where she fell. Plus 1, plus 3 versus undead. So 1d8 plus 1, except if it's undead, plus 3. That's awesome. It's a one-handed weapon. So this is 1d8 plus 1. This is 1d6 plus 1. Yeah. We'll have him use this. So now we've got this undead destroyer. 1d8 plus 1. And 1d8 plus 1 or plus 3 if undead. Minsk. Moving up in the world. Now, he's got... Whistling Sword plus 2. 1d6 plus 2. That's a regular 1d6 plus 1. So we've got some more stuff to identify, but I don't know. Oh, these are my level 2 spells. Yeah, I'm out. Out of curiosity. Armor class 3. Potion of magic blocking. What else do we have? Fiery burning. Resistance. Potion of power. Also thieving abilities. Yeah, I'm not sure what to do with that. I guess I'll hold that there. Stone form. Drinking this potion results in a transformation much like the one the imbiber would go through if she was turned to stone. Skin, color, stiffness, even the feeling that is received from the body. Stone. Why would anybody drink this? It improves your saving throws. I guess we'll be selling that. Okay, so we've got to identify these two things. What's that?
Full plate and packing steel.
The stone tunnels of the Nashkel Mines constrain your dreams tonight. The twisting depths are more a nuisance than claustrophobic now. What with the hidden marauders dead at your feet, deeper you tread, chuckling over your triumph at each body you see, pausing occasionally to wipe your boots clean or check the odd kobold for coins you might have missed. There is a sound from below, and you quickly move towards it. A door opens, and before you stands Mullahay, in no better shape than you left him. Held from whatever afterlife calls it, this specter has apparently been waiting for you. A dagger of bone hovers before it, ready for a willing hand to drive it deep. Had this creature breath, you were sure it would be hurling curses. It waits for the kill, a death beyond death, and knows no hope, rightfully so. You brush aside the quaint blade and bring your hands around the creature's neck. A stranger's weapon simply will not suffice in this matter. You must be certain this phantom remains among the dead. It is strange, though. Doomed as he is, Mullahay still looks somewhat relieved. His visage fades within your grasp and leaves you clutching at empty air. A puzzling turn, but of little concern. The mine is yours once again. You turn to leave, but find the exit blocked. The lone dagger has become five, a skeletal set of claws that hovers before you. A talon extends and presses against your chest. And a hollow voice chills the air. You should use the tools you are given. It traces a line of ichor on your tunic, increasing in pressure. Listen to what is bred in the bone. There is a flash of motion as the claws push deep into your chest. You awake in an instant, the sound of mourning a welcome clamor. You're intact, and though tired, you are certainly not afraid. Your heart is not your weak spot.
Really? You should use the tools you are given. Listen to what is bred in the bone. So it's like I enjoyed killing Mullahay this time in my dream. Perhaps a little too much. Oh, I got Larlock's Minor Dream. That's not that great. I mean, oh, that's right. I keep forgetting I have healing. I gotta try to remember that. I'm not used to my character, a mage, having healing. But, yeah, special ability. Now I got Larlock's Minor Dream and Cure Light Wounds. Alright, well, let's identify this stuff. Magical darts. Oh, dart of wounding. I know what it is. Okay. This dart is coated in a deadly poison that will immediately seep into the bloodstream if striking an opponent with very deadly results. So that's what was thrown at Khalid. Target must save versus death. That's what it is. Save versus death, or take 20 points of poison damage in 20 seconds. Well, he could survive through that if he wasn't also being slashed and hacked at the same time. Plus, it might be cumulative for multiple darts. Well, okay. Dart of Wounding. could use that. Oh, okay. Hour of fire plus one. Now I know what they are again. Plus one or plus two? Plus two. Like these. Okay, we got a nice collection of those. That's good for a thief. Invisibility. Was one of those weird potion of healings that I don't know if I should trust. Stuff to sell now. We have to sell this moon blade because only Zan can use it. Yeah, that's everything. Okay. Let us rest. Oh, let's restore everything. I didn't have to use any of them. I hate that. What else did I have? Charm potion. Chromatic orb.
Point, I punch.
Making sure no one needs to level up. It's easier than squinting and seeing the little thing on the characters' portraits.
Full plate and packing steel.
Restoring my spells back to their normal configuration. Okay. He doesn't buy stuff, does he?
Squeaky wheel gets the kick.
Oh wait, Thunderhammer's this way. I guess we'll visit some inns and talk to people that want to talk to us. Well, it's the leader of the Flaming Fist that wants to talk to us. The other one might not be expecting us. Officer Vi. Do we need bullets? That's what I wonder. I have plenty for now. Yeah, I think we're good on them for now.
Let's talk butt kicking for goodness!
Alright. We got a lot of crap to sell. Medium shield, just one. Yeah. Guess it wasn't not really worth it to pick up shields. I'll try to remember that. The mail and chain mail and splint mail are a different subject. But yeah, 80 there. It's pretty nice. We can't sell the Moonblade plus 3. Wonder if someone else would buy it. Look at that. Protector of the second plus 2. Awesome. Oh, we have any gems in here? Yes. Nothing here, okay. Okay. Wow, I got a lot of money.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
I wonder what we need to increase reputation. How much? We're still despised territory.
Full plate and packing steel.
I mean, we have money.
I'll not have a part in this. Change your course, lest I be forced to stop you.
I'm gonna try and make you feel more happy about us, Khalid.
Full plate and packing steel.
Didn't I try 500 before and it didn't work? I wish I could speed this up. If we just get up 1 point, I believe we're out of despised territory. Can I type it? Okay. Wait. Your donation to the church was greatly appreciated and your reputation has gone up by 1 point. There's been a big influx of Flaming Fist into town lately. I don't know what all the extra troops are for, but it puts me on edge. Certainly it does. Members of the Flaming Fist have been transferred to Baragos. Their presence is apparently of little comfort to the locals. Well, there's one who accosted me.
I am proud to stand among such strong warriors.
Branwen's happy now. Yeah, we were, killed by one of them. In Baragos. I guess there's just
good
more...
Good on you if you save the day.
More of them now. So we are now disliked. 5. Should I increase it more? I hope we don't need to use the money for something more, like, even more important. Got up by another point. It's been really slow of late, with all the raiders making the roads so dangerous, no one's willing to travel anymore. I wish the Flaming Fist would do something about those bandits.
Perhaps this group needs not quite as much help as I thought.
People are angry that the Flaming Fist has been unable to stop the bandit attacks. Travel has slowed greatly. Alright, so let's look now. We're still disliked, but 6. Not 5.
Gorion would be proud of your actions.
I'm glad you feel better about us, Khalid.
Butt kicking for goodness!
We'll try to get
Freaky
it.
Wheel gets the kick.
Even better than this life.
Camaraderie, adventure, and steel on steel. The stuff of legend, right, Boo?
Beep. So
I am proud to stand among such strong warriors.
See, everyone's so happy now. It was worth it. 1,400 gold. Meh.
Kicking for goodness!
Alright. Alright, let's talk to this Officer Vi from the Flaming Fist.
Can I assist you?
Ah, Sapphire. I thought it might be you. These southern parts are set quite afire with talk of your work in Nashkel. I am Officer Vi of the Flaming Fist, and to be honest, I could use your help. Reading that first option. I am honored to be found worthy of your notice, officer. How may I be of assistance? My contingent and I are cut off from Baldur's Gate. We haven't received new orders for close to a week, and to be honest, I don't like the feel of this at all. The bandit raids have been getting worse since you returned from Nashkel. I used to think that they were just your usual brigands out to make a quick buck in troubled times, but not anymore. They're working for someone. One way or another, I've got to get my troops back to the gate. I'll pay 50 gold for every bandit scalp you can bring me, and spread the news. I want this whole region cleared before winter comes. You recently sold a couple bandit scalps. 50 gold pieces for every bandit scalp. Officer Jessa Vi. Of the Flaming Fist is marooned in Baragos with her contingent. In her desperation to return to Baldur's Gate, she's offered me 50 gold pieces for every bandit scalp I can bring her. She'll be waiting for me at the Jovial Juggler Inn. How can we tell they're bandit scalps? I mean, it could be just some innocent person. I mean, maybe the hair is unwashed because they're bandits. But there are dirty people of all kinds, except for nobles, normally. Alright, I will give you scalps.
Full plate and packing steel.
I hope your travels have gone well, Sapphire. Remember, if you want the reward for dead bandits, you have to bring me their scalps. A rather bloody task, but I must have some proof. I wonder if we can buy them back from the Feldepost Inn.
Butt kicking for goodness!
I think I remember seeing them in his inventory. So as long as he's selling them for less than 50, we could make some money. Granted, he still has them, of course. And we have to go to Feldepost anyway to meet this, or talk to this guy. Oh, all our quests went away? Ugh. We could still do them, right? I didn't realize our quests would go away. Disappear off of here. Oh, I can write stuff. So we have to talk to Tranzig. I never found the half-ogres. I wonder if you can still do that. I'll post in, okay. That's Hephaestus, not Tranzig.
Butt kicking for goodness! Excuse me.
Upstairs, maybe? Maybe. Yeah. Could be in back, but I think upstairs then. Algernon. Here's Tranzig.
Full plate and packing steel.
What is it? A
simple
matter.
To me, like these men want a little trouble.
Why do you bother me?
I'll give them trouble.
Can't you see that I'm in a hurry to get out of this damn town? Branwen says, why the hurry, Tranzig? You delay the inevitable. What? Who do you think you are, woman? Is it so commonplace for you to turn others to stone, mage? Oh, he's the same one to turn her to stone. You! How did you... I said I would see you dead before I see the shores of the Isles once more. Coward, and in Tempest's name I shall. Prepare yourself. ghost armor.
Such menial tasks.
I give up. Please, let me live. I'll tell you anything you want to know. You shall get no quarter from us, fiend. In Tempest's name, I will strike you down. We need him alive, Branwyn. If you are indeed indebted to me, you'll cease your attack. Then get what you need from me. Get what you need from him. I will deal with this coward later. By Tempest, I swear it. Spill your guts, then. If what you say satisfies us, then we'll let you live. Okay, I'll talk. Too bad the music's still going. I'm a messenger for a man named Tazok. I just ferry messages between him and a fat priest named Mullahy. I meet with Tazok at either Palvale or Larswood, east of the Friendly Arm Inn. Tazok pays me good, so I keep my app shut. Can I go now? Where can we find this Tazok? Tazok? You can find him in the Wood of Sharp Teeth. He's the captain of two groups of bandits. Their camp's always moving, so I don't know how much luck you'll have in finding them. Can I get out of here now? The world map has been updated and journal updated for bandits. Yeah, get out of our sight. Wait.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Seems to me like these men want a little trouble. I'll get in trouble.
I should travel to Larswood or Palvale next. It appears that the bandit attacks come from there and are related to the iron shortage. There should be a base hidden away somewhere in the forests. After dealing with Tranzig, I learned where I might find Tazok. He was supposed to meet Tranzig in Palvale or Larswood, both just east of the Friendly Arm Inn. Alright.
Cool wants some. Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Those stairs want some.
Butt kicking for goodness! Full plate and packing steel.
I still want to find the half ogres. Maybe the quest will resume if we find them. We'll appear back on our map again. See, it doesn't even. There's nothing even in. Oh, yeah. Tranzig and I had it out at Feldepost Inn in Paragos. Looking through Mullahy's letters, I see he was in cahoots with the bandits. He probably knows where they make their camp. Once he saw things my way, Tranzig confessed that he was a messenger for the bandits, delivering letters between one Tazok and the late, unlamented Mullahy. Well, you should get some more rest.
Kicking for goodness!
And we could sell a few things that we couldn't otherwise. Here we could sell Mullahy's holy symbol. So I wonder if we'll need the empty bottle for something. So I'll hold on to it. Winter wolf pelt? Well, that guy in. Oh, that's right, and we want to see if we can buy the bandit scalps. The guy in Nashkel buys them. We'll see if he buys them for more than 250. He won't buy the Moonblade either, no surprise. Yeah, all right. We can buy the bandit scalps for 97 and only get 50 back for them, so never mind. So all the crap we sold him all this time. Alright. Alright, where are the rest? Because I did use some spells.
Full plate and packing steel.
Alright, so next episode, guys, we'll be heading back to Nashkel. Hopefully the Omnian soldiers don't come after us, now that we've increased our reputation. Hopefully. They might, in which case we might have to, I don't know, improvise something. We need to talk to Baron Gaskill, and we need to try to sell
Orion
this...
Orion would have none of this. It is shameful.
Oh, God. You were proud of our actions just a few minutes ago. Sell a Wonderwolf pelt to the general store there. I think that's all we need to do with those two things. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.